I met Alfie while sparring at Premier.
How old are you?
23, just turned 23. A month ago now, so.
How long have you been training for?
I've been there for like 2 years now. At first, it was just a sort of a twice a week hobby. A couple years later, yeah, I'm my first semi-pro fight. I've done on the competitions, the mats, this and that. But yeah, my first semi-pro in front of sort of a few hundred people in a hall, entrance music, the lights, this and that. So yeah, it's the first one, I guess.
I mean, they've got to weigh in Friday, although they're not training Friday. It's a big shock to the system when you're cutting weight to weigh in, so I really don't want them doing it. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday should be chewing. By Saturday, I want them to be itching Saturday. Not itching. Rearing a punch in the face. So yeah, Alfie's making his debut.
I'm confident in myself. I think this is well overdue. I think I'm better than any of the guys that I'm going to be coming against at this level. I really do think that I'm featherweights have got a problem in me. They're going to have a problem. Living at the end of my dad's garden still, eh, man? Just trying to make the dream work. Hopefully get out of here soon. This is the shed, man. Big Family Guy fan, so got that going on. Correct me if I'm wrong, Pulp Fiction film. That's that one. It's a little twist on Banksy's thing there. Stormtroopers. Che Guevara.
Che.
Hero of mine, bro.
What'd you like about Che?
He was a doctor in Argentina. And then gave all that up to fight for something he believed in. Someone that's willing to give up their life and pursue something they believe in. It's got a fascination for me, man.
He'll be back in it, he's just beating as well. I thought it was actually 6-8, it's actually my mistake.
His opponent has failed his weigh-in and is 3 kgs over. Alfie is pissed.
What happens, bro?
That's what it is, man. Didn't make weight, but it's cool. Yeah, man. Okay, I'm ready.
I was impressed by Alfie. He hadn't backed down from fighting someone clearly bigger and heavier than him.
Guys come in 3 kg heavy. No, that's not no mistake, man. This guy's obviously not really bothered about the weights. So now tomorrow they obviously think they've got me set up, man. This week I could have been eating healthy, training this and that, lifting heavy at the gym still, you know? But today I've been struggling to get my weight down, this and that. To be honest, man, I'm just feeling to embarrass this guy tomorrow night. Now he's embarrassed himself by not making weight. Yeah, the promoter's embarrassing himself by trying to cover for it. Can't come up with fucking excuses and this and that. Bro, now I've heard this bullshit, I'm telling you, I'm gonna kill him.
Fight night.
Fucking showtime, baby. I'm telling you, I can't even describe this right now, man. Any night out, anything out, give me this, bro. Give me this. I'm telling you. Absolutely in love right now, man.
When are you fighting?
Fight number 7. Mate, I just want to get out of there, get this going now, man.
I think we need to get a couple of cheers. It's Alfie's first time he's getting his hand wrapped. Let's do it properly. Oh, just look.
An appropriate song, no? Don't call it a comeback.
Two other Premier boys have already won, piling on the pressure on rookie Alfie, who fights next. We're ready, Alfie. You'll fight next. Enough,
ready now.
Okay,
right now.
He's fucking getting up
now.
Hold up, hold up.
Relax, relax. Alfie. Alfie, mate. Alfie.
It's all in.
Chris, do your thing, Alfie.
Sure. Alfie. Yeah, remember that. It will come.
Sir.
The W will come and it will come in style,
yes,
not with fuck it, a bit scrappy, won't it?
Sir.
Right? It will come with style.
Yes, sir.
Let's go.
Let's go, baby.
You got this, man.
Right?
Yeah, feel that. Feel that.
And fighting out of the blue corner from Premier MMA.
About me, this fight's about me and where I want to go, and I don't train as hard as I train to say, oh well, I'm gonna go in there and give it a shot. I train so hard, I'm gonna kill this guy. I just went to a different place. Like my mind just completely relaxed, and I was focused, homing in on this guy, and I felt nothing. Like I couldn't hear anything. It was just pure peace. Like I felt at home. It was incredible feeling. And then bam, they call your name. Boof, everyone starts getting loud, and that was an incredible feeling. You go down the rent thing, all your friends are there, they've all pushed their way to the side of the barriers and they want to shake your hand and shit as you go through, and yeah man, that was a really peculiar feeling. Bro, I'm fucking electric right now, man, seriously. I want to do that for the rest of my life, man. That right there, innit, that rush, you see that, all of that, man. I'm in love, turn.
After his win, I thought Alfie would be on it, and keen to get another fight. But whilst filming at Premier, I noticed he wasn't around as much. And then I got a phone call months later, saying something had happened to him.
I got stabbed in the leg by a knife, big fuck off pirate knife. And yeah, just straight in my thigh. It makes you feel a bit sick, eh? It does make you feel a little bit sick. Kinda just don't think about it being my leg. But yeah, it's that was a painful night, eh, man? That was a painful night.
I think you need to be aware of your own mortality to truly be hungry. And I guess I kind of got myself into a bubble where life's gonna be perfect and it's all just gonna run how you want it to, you know? And I think it takes a bump along the road to get you back on track and get you going through again, you know? And that's what's happened. This whole thing, it shook me up. And I've come back a better fight already. And I can't wait to get back into class, start getting my movement going again, start doing stuff differently again. And I gonna show Sir what he saw in me last year.
I want to stay undefeated. I want to be in the UFC undefeated. I'm fighting for the BAMMA one, British title. That's going to be by far the biggest.